needs to be congratulated for this piece of legislation. Because
Vice Speaker B.J. Cruz gives accolades to current U.S. Attorney General Alicia Limtiaco for Bill 41 because she had discussed with him a stateside case in which a mother pretended to be a friend of her daughter's and sent a horrible email which resulted in the girl committing suicide. He remembers how both of them agreed it was important and critical.
We really have to address this. We're in the 21st century. They're not only beating kids up at school, but unfortunately, we're now doing quite a bit of cyberbullying with the internet and social media. And we've got to figure out a way that we can address that issue.
The bill was recently heard on session floor, and he commends his colleagues for recognizing the importance of the legislation. Bill 41 to amend Guam code related to bullying, cyberbullying, and sexting passed. Cruz notes that one of the reasons was in due part to the turnout of parents who spoke out during the bill's public hearing. Senators realized that too many kids were being hurt by the physical act of bullying, and now more recently the digital act of bullying in cyberspace. With popular social networks like Facebook and MySpace, Cruz believes there should be some sort of filtering. Recent introduction of programs in schools such as GREAT and the PBIS give hope to the senator that kids are being provided the necessary tools to know that cruel words and a flying fist are not right.
It's just as wrong to send nasty messages over the internet about somebody as it would be to punch me out like they used to do in the yards at school. That's just as wrong as hitting somebody over the head with a 2x4, and sometimes is even more painful, because sometimes being beat up, only one or two people witness it. But when it's on the social media, everybody sees it on your Facebook, everybody sees it on your MySpace, and it can be viral within minutes. The consequences are too tragic.
The former juvenile court judge finds it ironic that Bill 41 stemmed from a parent being horrible and stresses the need for parents to provide guidance. He praises DOE for stepping in if parents aren't doing so.
I really applaud for the Department of Education for they're starting some kind of educational program, because it's imperative that if they're not getting it at home, then we've got to address it at school and have them understand that this kind of behavior is unacceptable.
Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Jonah Gonchafres.